Hi guys, today I'm going to be hauling books that I found for 50 cents each. So I live by a chain of bookstores called Bull Moose, and they sell like DVDs and music and stuff as well. They're actually probably known more for their music, but I go there for their books because they do new and pre-owned books. I'm a frugal shopper. I love a good deal, and they have several bins of 50 cent books, and a lot of them are mass market paperbacks that are just really beat up, or hardcovers that like you've never heard of, but sometimes you find a really good deal, like a diamond in the rough. Very recently, I went to one of their locations and they had several of their pre-owned books that have just been sitting on the shelves. They were in really good condition, but they just hadn't sold. So they were just trying to get rid of them for 50 cents each so that they could make room for new pre-owned books. And I happened to walk in like as they were stickering them. So there was like this huge pallet of hardbacks in excellent condition, all for 50 cents. So I went a little crazy. These aren't all from that particular trip. These are kind of books that I've found over time from there. Usually you only find like one or two really good deals, but because of that recent trip that I had and the fact that I go there so often, I have this stack of books that, again, are my diamonds in the rough. They were like a thrill to find. And it's part of why I go to those bookstores so often is like, I just love finding a good deal. So yeah, I'm excited to share them with you. So I'm gonna start with a couple books that I've actually already hauled, but where they're in the same category of 50 cent books. I'm just gonna quickly show them again. Over a month ago, actually, I found The Dragon Republic by R.F. Kuang for 50 cents. This one looks pretty good other than like a Sharpie mark. And then there's like a sticker smudge up here, but otherwise it looks fantastic. The spine is perfect. It's not like bent or cracked or anything. So I found this one and I didn't own the Poppy War yet. I have since purchased it. It's kind of funny actually because I accidentally purchased two copies of the Poppy War. So I ended up spending like $40 on the Poppy War where I found this one for 50 cents. So cost-wise, kind of evened out, but this was still a really good deal. And I have an extra copy of the Poppy War to give my best friend. So it's funny how that worked out, but this was still a really great find. And then the other one I've already hauled is the Inheritance Trilogy by N.K. Jemisin. This is obviously the entire trilogy, so it's three books in one. So I figured for 50 cents, that was an awesome deal. I'm in the middle of the fifth season right now by N.K. Jemisin, and her writing is excellent. It's unlike anything I've ever read, really. She uses second person point of view, which is very strange. And not like across the board, but it is something that she utilizes, at least in the fifth season. So I want to get through that trilogy before I tackle the Inheritance Trilogy, but I'm really liking her writing so far. So I was really excited to find this one for 50 cents. Next up is a book I found literally the other day. And this was so exciting because this is a brand new release. I'm pretty sure it came out in November of last year. So that was only a couple months ago. To me, this copy looks perfect. There's only one thing wrong that I can see with it, and I don't know if it was accidental or on purpose, but that's Master of One by Jada Jones and Danny Bennett. I know this was either like a Fairy Loot or an Illumicrate pick sometime in the last couple months. I don't have those boxes, so I'm not sure, but I have seen it on YouTube. So that's where I first heard about it, and I was really intrigued. So when I saw this in the 50 cent bin, this was like buried, by the way. So this wasn't like sitting on top. I have no idea why it was there, because as you can see, it's totally clean. The pages look good. The only thing I can see is that it's got like a Sharpie mark, and I usually only see these on bargain books. That's how they mark them as bargain books. So I don't know. This is a new release. It shouldn't be in the bargain section by any means anywhere. So I have no idea. I've paid more for used books in worse condition than this. So this was a crazy find. I had a really good feeling about going to the bookstore that day, and I'm so glad I did because this alone was worth the trip. I think I spent less than $20 that day, and the savings alone in the 50 cent books that I had was crazy. So I'm really excited to read this at some point. I have the audiobook on hold at my local library. So once I get that, I would like to read and listen to that at the same time. Really excited for this one. The other book that I found in that same trip is Red Rising by Pierce Brown. I have heard excellent things about this series. This copy is definitely beat up. It's paperback and the spine is is been through some stuff, but I've heard really good things. I'm only just now getting into sci-fi more recently, so I figured I would pick this up for 50 cents to see if I liked it. I know that it is well-loved, but just in case. And if I do really end up loving it, I'll upgrade to a better copy probably, because I like hardcovers. But yeah, this was a really good deal, and it's like, I think a great way to test drive a series if you're not sure if you're gonna like it or not. If you find a copy for 50 cents, why the heck not, you know? So very excited for this one. Getting into some of the books that I found during that day where they were just getting rid of stuff is The Crane Wife by Patrick Ness. I recognize Patrick Ness. I've never read anything of his yet, but I have a couple things on my shelf, my TBR shelf by him, particularly The Knife of Never Letting Go from the Chaos Walking trilogy. So I'm excited to read that, but this is like a little short one and it's older. I don't know when exactly it came out. And reading the synopsis, it sounded kind of familiar. This man finds like a crane in his garden, and then later he meets a woman who is confused and lost, and I believe she's the crane. It sounds kind of like a magical realism, kind of fairy tale story. Again, I haven't read anything by Patrick Ness yet, but he is an author that I'm looking to get into, so I thought this was a cool find. Next up is a book that I actually pulled for my March TBR. If you haven't seen that video, I picked my March TBR blindfolded, and this is one of the ones that I grabbed, Nine Perfect Strangers by Leanne Moriarty. I've only ever read Big Little Lies from her, which was another book actually that I found from Bull Moose for 50 cents. So I'm on a roll with her books, I guess. They're really popular, but this is a Book of the Month edition. So these don't usually go for a whole lot because they're a Book of the Month edition, but they're still usually around like $5 to $10. But again, they were just looking to get rid of this one, so it's in really good shape. There's a little bit of scuffing on the back, but honestly, when it's sitting on your shelf, you just see the spine, so I'm not mad about that at all. I don't know a whole lot about this one other than there's like, I think it's like rich people problems. They go to like a health retreat or something, and everybody's got like a secret. I'm very interested in reading this because I did like Big Little Lies so much. So for 50 cents, I was like, heck yeah. Next up is another book that was a Book of the Month choice, but this is not a Book of the Month edition, and it's The Wife Between Us by Greer Hendricks and Sarah Pekkanen. I know they've written a couple of books together. I can't recall any of the names of them right now, but I've never read any of them. So when I saw this one for 50 cents, I figured like I'd like to see what the hype is about. I feel like people really like these books. And I think they're like domestic dramas or domestic thrillers, which those are always fun. I read a lot of like fantasy and romance, but I do like to break it up with some like thriller drama every now and then. And this one's pretty short too. At least it looks it. I guess it's just over 300 pages. I don't know when I'll get to this one, but I don't like passing up the deals when I find them, so if I'm interested in reading them at all, for 50 cents, I'll usually grab it. This one has been sitting on my TBR shelf for a while, but I am interested in getting to it eventually. Keeping it up with the Book of the Month finds I found, I also picked up When We Were Vikings by Andrew David McDonald. I'm not entirely sure what this is about, but I really loved the cover. I liked the little Viking helmet. That really drew me in. And I think this has to do with like two siblings, and the sister is like really interested in Viking history and like Norse mythology and stuff. Her older brother is like going through some stuff. I don't remember, right? I don't know exactly what, but she tries to like draw on her like love of Vikings to find strength or something, and I'm not quite sure what to expect with this one, but I've liked most of the Book of the Month choices that I've read, so usually when I see the little logo, I'm willing to give it a chance, so I'm excited to read this one. Next up is a book that was kind of a funny find. I've seen the cover quite a bit, and I thought it looked really interesting, but I had no idea what it was about. I'd seen it on Book Outlet a couple of times, but it was never quite like the right price for me to kind of take the chance on it. It has kind of a low rating on Goodreads, and the author, Melissa Broder, just came out with another book called Milk Fed. That, I was like, the cover keeps catching my eye, but I'm not like super interested in reading it. But then I found out she was also the same author that wrote The Pisces, this one. So it's just like one of those things where I'd read a lot about this book very recently, and then I found it in this 50 cent bin that day that they were just getting rid of a bunch of stuff. So I figured for 50 cents, I was kind of willing to take the chance. You know, I don't typically try to rely too heavily on Goodreads ratings because, you know, I do tend to like books that are low rated on Goodreads and high rated on Goodreads. So I try not to base it solely on that. This book I've read is kind of weird, and It's about a woman who falls in love with a merman, and I don't know if it's particularly got Shape of Water vibes, but that's kind of what it reminded me of when I was reading the synopsis. So you have like this illustration of this woman and she's hugging a fish, but I believe he's more of a, like a merman like figure in the book. I have no idea what to expect from this. I'm expecting a little bit of weirdness and some strange things, but I don't mind strange every now and then. But yeah, again, for 50 cents, I figured why not. Next up is The Book of Essie by Megan McLean Weir. From what I understand, this book is sort of, it reminds me of The Duggars, the reality TV show about that family, where Essie is the daughter of an evangelical preacher and they have like a reality TV show and she ends up pregnant. It's a drama about that where she comes from like this super religious background. You know, should they try to get her to have an abortion or should she publicly be, you know, a teenager that's pregnant and not married in the public eye. I'm curious about that again because it reminds me a little bit of the Duggar situation, and that's never a show I really got into, but I feel like it was at the forefront of pop culture quite a while ago. So I thought it was interesting that someone kind of wrote a book. I don't know if it was necessarily inspired by that, but it seems close enough. But yeah, it sounded interesting, and for 50 cents, I was like, okay, let's do it. And last up, we have a book that I picked up a while ago, actually. This has been sitting on my TBR for quite some time. It was also 50 cents. I found this in the bin. And it's called The Immortalists by Chloe Benjamin. I know Noel Gallagher did not like this book, but I'm curious about it. And 50 cents, again, is basically free. So I figured I'd try it out. And I believe this has to do with a couple of, like, four friends. They sneak out as teenagers to hear their fortune from like a traveling carnival or psychic or something, and they all find out the days they're supposed to die. And I believe at first they don't take this quite seriously, but then when the first friend does die, when he was prophesied to, it kind of sinks in for the rest of them, and you follow each of their lives up until the point in which they pass away. So I thought that sounded kind of spooky. Again, sort of like a magical realism element. So I'm intrigued. I don't know if I'll love it, but I definitely want to check it out at some point. Maybe in the fall, actually. It's got a little bit of a spooky vibe. So yeah. All right, and those are all my 50 cent books. Again, I love the thrill of the hunt for a good deal. I'm really lucky to live by a bookstore that does these deals. It's cool that they price them so low because otherwise I've literally heard an employee tell me that like they'd end up in the trash. So I feel better about grabbing these. I do have a bit of a book hoarding problem, but I figure where I'm getting such a good deal, and two, I'm saving them from a landfill. It's not quite so bad. I could have worse addictions, I suppose. So yeah, so thanks for watching. Feel free to like and subscribe. If you like this video, I really would appreciate you subscribing. I upload twice a week and we just talk about books here, and I'd love to have you. So thanks so much for watching and have a great day. Bye.